Behavior expert Dr. Wendy Walsh joins me now. Wendy, it breaks my heart to just read that story, and we all know about it, but it's terrible. So Wendy Maeve Ryan says,
tragic.
Yeah, she had to tell LaShawn not to blame himself, but what do you have to do to make a child believe that? Because
I had also heard one report that he had told her he'd wished he had taught his other brothers how to swim. Oh. So he was already blaming himself. You know, the thing we know about psychology is sometimes people come through some pretty rough emotional experiences and grow up to be somewhat functional. And then the reverse. Some people are what we might term delicately scathed in childhood and have deep dysfunction in adult life. So we really don't know how the biology is going to play out. But most importantly, he does need to get help and support, as clearly his mother needed before. And I hate to get on a soapbox, but Don, 40% of American babies are born out of wedlock. What population of single mothers? Where's the village supporting these women? Where are the baby daddies? Where are the extended family? Where are the services for a mother to reach out when she's not doing so well?
Yeah. You know, and as you were talking there, I was just looking at the video of the little boy. Of course, we don't show his face, but it's just, I can't imagine at that moment what he was going through. And one other point I want to make, LaShawn told Ryan that no driver would stop for him, Dr. Wendy, a 10-year-old boy on the side of the road, half-clothed, and no one helps him. What's going on there?
You know, I'm going to go there. This is racism. And we don't
really?
Know I don't know how big this child was, but I happen to have a 12-year-old daughter who's multiracial, who's 5'8". So, you know, this child could have been perceived as a young black man at the side of the road. Oh, my gosh, a threat. I mean, it's so disturbing. Mm. But I can only imagine if a 10-year-old white boy was standing there, how many cars would have passed by. I'm sorry, but this really bothers me.
Mm. It's just sad. I can't imagine someone half clothed on the side of the road. Even if they didn't flag me down, I'd probably pull over or stop and say, are you okay? Do you need something? But unfathomable. Okay, let's move on to older kids here.
Mm-hmm.
At a Massachusetts high school, two Facebook emails have been floating around that name 22 girls who do not have a date to the junior prom, rating them by size and sexual experience. Okay, so Ipswich High administrators have condemned the email, so how should the school punish the person, likely a student, who wrote these emails?
Well, if they have trouble identifying that perpetrator who is breaking some online bullying laws right now, they need to just say no prom until somebody gives him up. Mm-hmm. Because this kind of thing, you know, the example I use now, what used to be subtle teasing and frothing and whatever you call it with kids is now set in stone in a digital world, and it's entered a new arena. In the 1940s, Don, when teenagers walked to school, if they stole a few apples from a farmer's tree, you kind of went, oh, they're teenagers. If they walked into a grocery store today and stole apples, they'd be prosecuted. These young teens should be prosecuted. They're breaking bullying laws, and we do know this kind of online humiliation and shame is as damaging as a physical injury. So I think these people need to, this whole generation of teenagers need to be trained. You're writing things in stone when it's out there electronically.
And we say it over and over, and it needs to be drilled into their heads. Also, there's something else in New England I want to talk about. A bill begs a question. What bathroom, Dr. Wendy, should transgendered people use? A Maine representative says business owners and schools who direct transgender people to use a restroom of their original sex should not be accused of discrimination. Do you think this is right?
Well, you know, the fact that we're having this conversation shows that now we're starting to become a little more progressive and understand just as there is a variety of sexual orientations in the human species, there are also a variety of genders. And we're going to learn to accept all kinds of variations on typically female and typically male. My answer is for everybody's comfort, the customers and the transgendered person, that they probably go into the bathroom that most matches their clothing, not necessarily their genitalia, so that everybody can be happy for now. But, you know, who knows?
Yeah, it's interesting because what you see in places like New York where there's not a lot of space, space is a premium. In restaurants, it's usually just, you know, it's the same unisex bathroom, so that's one way to solve all that, let everybody go to the same bathroom.
In Italy, when I lived in Italy, I had to get used to that there were men in the ladies' room because there was just one bathroom. It was unisex. And now that I've got kids, we're in family restrooms. Come on, let's just have one bathroom.
Yeah, this is America.
And a little more privacy.
You know how we are here in America.
Yeah.
Okay, so from sexuality to sex, in Philadelphia, the city health department is promoting condom use for boys as young as 11 years old. What should parents think about their kids? Should they allow their kids to do this? What do you think of this?
I think it's fabulous. Remember, condoms are not a sex toy. They're a health instrument. And anything that protects our children from sexually transmitted diseases or pregnancy is good. And obviously, they wouldn't be developed and they wouldn't be giving them away if there wasn't a market and a need for them. So parents need to be talking to their kids about sexuality earlier in life. If you're going to wait till your child's 13 to have the talk, guess what, mm-hmm. Mom? You're too late because our media has gotten a hold of your kid.
I can tell you, when my mom, my parents wanted to have the talk with me, I'm like, I already know that. My friends had already told me.
You're right.
So they were way too late.
Yeah, you're so late.
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks,
the
Dr.
time to start is when they say, when they're young, when they're 2 and 3 and 4 and say, how'd the baby get in there?
And Dr. Wendy is in New York. Have fun with your two daughters in New York. Hope
Thanks.
You enjoy it for spring break, okay?
We will.
All right.
Thanks, Dawn. See you next week.
Thank you.